Brookhurst International School. We believe that our students have a variety of talents that can only be exploited if they are given platforms to express themselves and to perform. As much as we insist on the discipline and the syllabus, we are aware that we have more than that that is required to survive in life. And therefore, that's why Brookhurst will continue creating platforms internally and externally to ensure that we expose students and we give them an opportunity to showcase their abilities. And today is such an event. I also want to declare that through the days I've observed these students practice and engage their parents to support them in buying a number of attires. Today is the time that we are going to witness your hard work and your input in this whole exercise. With those few remarks, I would like to declare this event officially open. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. been abandoned by the dwarves. She went inside and hid there. She missed her father, but she could not go back home. In the meantime, the seven dwarves were heading home from a long day of working in their jewel mines. When they opened the door, you can imagine their surprise when they saw their cottage all cleaned up. What is this? It's hurting me. Snow White was sleeping on the bed upstairs. Snow White woke up from her sleep. The seven dwarfs could tell she was as surprised as they were. Soon, they all relaxed and shared their stories. Snow White learned their names: Bashful, Dog, Dopey, Grumpy, Happy, Sleepy, and Sneezy. She told them all about her stepmother, and that her stepmother had tried to get the huntsman to kill her, and that the huntsman had set her free in the woods, and that she could never go back home again. The dwarfs told her that she could stay with them. They had many books, and they asked Snow White to read for them. Back at the castle, the queen marched up to her mirror. She demanded, "Snow White is the fairest of them all."
"That's not possible. Snow White is dead."
"Snow White lives. She is living in the cottage of the seven dwarfs." The queen was very angry. Snow White heard a knock at the door.
"Is that the old one?" "I'm sorry, but I cannot open the door for anyone. Have mercy on me."
Snow White felt pity for the old lady and opened the door. She did not recognize the queen because she had disguised herself. The queen gave her an apple. Snow White took a bite, but she did not know that the apple was poisoned. She fell on the ground. The queen was very happy. Just then, the door flew open. In marched the seven dwarfs, home from the day's work. Shocked indeed they were to find Snow White lying on the floor, and what must be her stepmother beside her laughing. They chased that evil queen out the door and into the storm. Up to the very top of a mountain, they chased her. All of a sudden, lightning hits the mountain. The queen fell, and she was never seen again. But there was nothing to help poor Snow White. She stayed absolutely still in her deep sleep. The seven dwarfs gently lifted her into a glass coffin. Day and night, they kept watch over her. It happened that the prince came into the forest and went to the dwarfs' house. He saw Snow White and he begged the dwarfs to let him take her away to his palace. The dwarfs refused, but they felt bad for the prince. They let him go with her. The prince touched Snow White's hand and Snow White woke up from her sleep. Now nothing stood in the way for Snow White and the prince to be together forever. They returned to the prince's kingdom and lived happily ever after.
Snow White and the seven dwarfs. Thank you.
Thank you. afternoon. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I'm a person of very few words, and it's an honor being given this opportunity to speak on behalf of the parents. You know, being a young parent, I'm so excited to attend each and every activity that is taking place in school. So thank you so much, Brookhurst, for giving us this chance. Oh, as parents, we are so excited. The memo we got, I think it's more of a reading event. So this means that Brookhurst has a reading culture, something that we appreciate. We are looking forward to more of such events where our kids get to showcase their talents. They showcase their talents, which is in our today world, talent is one of the things that is appreciated. Thank you so much, and we are looking forward to having an amazing evening. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon, everyone. How are you all? Oh, wow. We've really enjoyed ourselves today just seeing, you know, how well organized and choreographed all the groups were. And I know this was done in record time. So we want to salute everyone who's been able to perform from year one. Okay, yes, Amari.
Jeremiah, go back and sit down.
And honestly, I didn't know my daughter can dance so much. We are shocked with the entire family. But isn't that the good thing about Brookhurst? Is you bring out talent that we don't recognize. So thank you all. By the way, this black tie has been a big deal in my house. We had to go shopping. How many parents went shopping? Yeah. We didn't understand. We Googled. My daughter here has robbed my whole wardrobe. So this is amazing fun. Thank you so much, Brookhurst.
Is coming to an end. The air is polluted, the ocean is contaminated, the animals are getting extinct, education is short, police are corrupt, ignorance is rewarded, and intelligence is rewarded while ignorance is shunned. The poor are depressed and angry. We can't live with each other, we can't live with ourselves, so everybody's medicated. We pass each other on the streets, and if we do speak, it's a meaningless robotic communication. More people want 15 seconds of fame than a lifetime of meaning and purpose, because what is popular is more important than what is right. Our government builds twice as many prisons and schools. It's easier to find a Big Mac than an apple, and when you find an apple, it's been genetically processed and modified. Presidents lie, politicians shikar, stress is still an issue, so is religion. Your God doesn't exist, my God does. He's all loving, and if you argue with me, I'll kill you, or worse, argue to death. 92% of the songs on the radio are about sex. Kids don't play tag, they play talk videos. The average person watches 5 hours of television a day. Yet there's more violence on the screens than ever before. Technology has given us everything we could ever want and at the same time stolen everything we really needed. Pride is at an all-time high while humility is at an all-time low. Everybody knows everything, everybody is going somewhere, blaming someone, ignoring somebody. There are not many human beings left, a lot of human doings, plenty of human lingerings in the past. Not many human beings. Money is still at the root of evil, yet we tell our kids, don't get that degree, the jobs don't pay well. Good deeds are done at a profit margin. The videos of the misfortunes of others go viral. We laugh and share them with our friends so that they can laugh with us. Our role models today, 60 years ago, would have been what not to be. There are states where one can legally be discriminated on the way they were born. Companies invest millions of dollars hiring specialists to make little girls feel like they need makeup to be beautiful, permanently lowering their self-esteem because they'll never be able to be pretty enough to meet those impossible beauty standards. So what can we do in the face of all this madness and chaos? What is the solution? We can love. Not the love that you hear on your favorite song, the radio. I mean real love, true love, boundless love. We can love each other from the moment we wake up to the moment we go to bed. From the moment we go to bed, portraying acts of kindness because it's contagious. We can be mindful during every interaction, planting seeds of goodness because, and ensuring a little more compassion than usual. Instead of blaming others, we can change ourselves, we can change our hearts. Our government has brainwashed us, made us not trust and recognize our brothers and sisters, to exhibit anger, hatred, and cruelty. But once we truly meet love, we'll be able to meet anger with sympathy, hatred with compassion, and cruelty with kindness. Love is the most powerful weapon on the face of the earth. Robert Kennedy once said, a few will be able to bend history, and each of us can work together to change a small portion of events, and in the total of those acts will be written a history of a generation. So yes, the world is coming to an end, and the path to a new one begins with you. Thank you.
You have a spoken word. Enjoy.
Soma, 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 kijana. Masiku zazidi badilika, kijana. Wazuri wazidi kuzaliwa na dunia. Na yaya zidi haribika, kijana.
At first nilikuwa bukom. Every time, book ndo form. Before I met the book flyers, who made sure I never used a high flyer. Before I knew it, walini introduced kwa first lover, who told me na kupenda all over. I remember walini show si rush kwa bash, cause vulnerability is real. What tingled in my mind was a song he sang to me all day long.
Uko sawa na wote malaika na mabawa yao. Wote wana kuiga wendo mama yao. Wewe na chagua sisemi na sisemi.
Nilijua niliwaluku, even though nilisahau buku, cause ni mimi tu nilikuwa na wazwa. What was the need of kufunzwa? All I did is lay with my lash, every day going to the bash. Sikujua I was killing my worth. Design my name ilitoka from lazy to baby. The fantasizing was real like crazy. I was a gift from heaven delivered to him. Kweli nilikuwa lazizi wake mi.
Zawadi nono kutoka binguni. Alini waza my baby. Akini ona usiku halali. Akini ona na wengine ashikwa na wivu. The next thing I'm seeing daisies. Home was my past tense, cause nothing my paro said was making sense. All I did ni kuvuka fence. My friends wakini show you only live once, so try these things once. Nikisema mi mtu wa soda only. Kumbe, my soda was spiked easy. Alone with friends ningedu. Kweli, asiyesikia la mkuu vunjika guu. I had already lost it. Gaining it is a process. Losing it is an easy contest. I had lost my worth. Was not ready for a rebirth. Juu. Sina makosa mimi usiniwie radhi. Nimetoka kupati. Na mzinga mimi ninayo lakini sijalewa. There was no more contest. Couldn't take the blame. I blamed them all. Was it my friends? Was it me? Was it the song? Uko sana, wote malaika na mabawa yao. Wote wanakwiga wendo mama yao. Wewe na chagua sisemi, sisemi. No guarantee. Grandly, none granted. The bookworm, now the streetworm. Depression. Wakisema she belongs to the streets. Vulnerability is real. Addiction is real. From bookworm to streetworm. Shush, ndo ilikuwa form. Nikisema it makes me feel better. It makes me feel greater. Until I lost it. I lost it all. I couldn't do it anymore. I couldn't live the same way, cause there was no more bid. I was tired of faking it. My days are long. Kweli nimepoteza my life so lost. Kweli ninatafuta, I miss you, mom. Kweli mimi nakupenda, I miss your love. I'm coming home. I had to sit down and challenge my choices. Cause every day is full of different chances. Lost my friends, lost my joy, lost my worth, lost time, lost me, lost all. Time for a rebirth. Time for a retake. East or west, home is best. Now building on a great future. Nikki. Soma, soma, soma. Kijana. Masiku zazidi badilika. Kijana. The song. Uko sawa na. Wote malaika na mabawa yao. Wote wanakwiga wendo mama yao. Niwewe na chagua sisemi. Left behind. The song no longer in mind. My future of a great kind. Creating with the great I find. Peer pressure led to love. Which led to drugs. Which led to loss. Let's stop PPL, DL. Peer, pressure, love, drugs, loss. At the right time, the right things come. My days are long. Kweli nimepoteza my life so lost. Kweli ninatafuta, I miss you, mom. Kweli mina kupenda, I miss your love. I'm coming home. Thank you.
today's event, the Black Tie Masquerade Friday, was extremely successful. This event is one of the series of activities that we do as an institution to expose talents and also to help students have fun when they are learning. So it's also an important activity because it gives our students a platform where the talents can be identified and nurtured. So we hope to keep doing more activities in future so that we expose our students here internally in school and of course internationally.
Hello, my name is Dennis and I am 8 years old. I am from Brookhurst International School. You are wondering why I'm looking like this, because it's Black Tie. Black Tie Friday is when you get to wear dresses for the girls and suits for the boys. Those dancing, singing, doing some plays, and I really like it.
Listen. Down my homie now, he cries, say we should die.
We shot him down.
He go left on it, say he picky, blicky, blah. They never do shit to me, cause he say he died. Uh-huh. He call my phony, boozy, picky, he like nigga cry. Yeah, you talking about gang, this shit. Uh-huh. You ever seen Sosa with the glow, man, it's a trip. Uh-huh. What a nigga lightning, this vice ain't been to me. Woo. Talk about my life, I get rich, every day's a sip. Told my papa, I got feature in this industry that he. He like man, we for lie, that anything to me. Uh-huh. Now my shorty call it, I'm picky, I'm busy to me. Low, hey,
yeah, I'm busy to me, hey.
Tell like I'm through, no playing, no internet, we gangsters. I can sell for snitches, me and my glow, we sell for snitches. She told me that she love me, she never knew that was a guest. So I'm call me so psycho, they only see me a nice. I can pretend I fuck you, chief, and no, guess I help her. Name I tell Bear Yambo, cause I like his music. Guest, Bear you dead, why you scared when you see me? Why you running? Boy, you scared, shout out, you know the drug. They be thinking I be tripping with the personality. FNE, we no hair, Pakistan D. But my record, get some cash, I'll be flexy. All my homies, they be rolling, they be flexy. That my homie now, he cry, he say we should die. He go left on his seat, he picky, blicky, blind.
No,
they never do shit to me, cause I say he died. He call my phony, boozy, picky, he like nigga cry. Man, you talking about gang, this
gang.
You ever seen Sosa with the glow? Man, he's a trip. What a nigga like this verse, anything to me. Talk about my life, I get rich, every day's a scene.
I'm in my zone, rolling from a different time zone. Run up on me and your mind froze. I don't even need to do the coat. I don't sipping that coat lean. I'm sipping heavy metal rapper. Run up on you when I shoot you like I'm in the trap. I'm run up on you. Hey, run up on me, I'm on my time. Run up on me, I don't waste time. I'ma shoot one time, I kill. And I'm pulling up with that drill. I'm with the AK brand new. I use that like the new. Nigga, I'm on the news, on the front pages. Pull up on you with a new Lambo. Nigga, I can go take your girl, right? Messing with me, I'ma pull up. Two bullets to your head, right? Nigga, I'm way too violent, I don't play with these girls, right? Pull up on you, I got a dudes. Run up, I'm nigga gonna lose.
Down my homie, now he cry, say we should die.
We should.
He go left on his seat, he picky, blicky, blind. They never do shit to me, cause he say he died. He call my phony, boozy, picky, he like nigga cry. Look, hey, wait.
Let's go.
Look, hey, wait. Listen. Freestyle,
laying in the silence, waiting for the siren signs, any signs, I'm alive still. I don't wanna lose it, but I'm not getting through this. Hey, should I pray? Should I pray? To myself, to a God, to a Savior who can unbreak the broken, unsay these spoken words, find open the hopeless, pull me out of the chain, unburn the ashes, and chain the reactions now. Not ready to die, not yet. Pull me out the chamber. Pull me out, pull me out. Underneath our bed, blood is the goddess and tone. Bad with the goddess and home, still a home, still a home here. It's not too late to build it back, cause one in a million chance is still a chance, still a chance. And I would take poison, unbreak the broken. I say these spoken words, find open the whole place. Pull me out of the train wreck. Unburn the ashes. Unchain the reactions now. Not ready to die, not yet. Pull me out of the train wreck. Pull me out, pull me out, pull me out. Pull me out. You can say what you like, don't say I wouldn't die for it. Oh, I'm down on my knees and I need you to be my God, be my help, be your savior. Okay, I'm brave, okay. I'd say these reckless words.
Me. Thank you very much. I'm Baba Mark Keremi, year 11. Baba Aida, Kisha, and Baba Isaac. This is my first, I'm hoping I'm going to pronounce it well. Masquerade? Yeah, when I read it first, I pronounced it differently. And I'm looking forward to a nice evening. I want to see more presentations. I'm already very excited at what I am seeing. Yeah, and I hope you're going to keep my adrenaline high. Is that right? Should I expect more? Should I expect more surprises? All right, thank you very much.
Let me just say I'm very excited to be here. This is my first time. I'm mother to Kerago and Wamboi Meshuki. We are very excited. What we've seen so far is fantastic. The presentations are good. The singing was good. I hope we shall see the people who've been singing doing very well, representing even the country, you know, making it even in the billboards. What we have seen is good. Keep it up and well done.
Oh, Tony, what shall we do? Since the journey. Oh, Tony. What shall we do?
We can stand up. Those who know to do salsa. Those who can join us for salsa.
Oh, Tony, what shall we do? What shall we do? Pasi papa pa morere pasi nara mo. Oh, Todi, what shall we do? Senzane. Oh, Todi, what shall we do? Senzane. Oh, Todi, What shall we do? Senzi chane.
What shall we do?
Oh, Tony. What shall we do? Senzi chane.
What shall we do?
Weight on my shoulders, oh, I believe in my God. Oh, I got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. I do what I can when I can, all I can for my people. When the clouds were back and the stars filled the sky, that's when I'm gonna stand. Take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new world. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling? Calling me to answer. Gonna keep on keeping on.
I can feel it in my bones.
Stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Across the river, you hear freedom calling, calling me to answer. Gonna keep on keeping on.
And I know that around the bend
community that mother-in-law can a bad sitting habit, one of our tengeneze, a good looking habit. Amaniaje, my friends, you guys are looking good, bana. Hey, kwani corona ilikonga inaonesha hivi?
I'm an effector, first dose, second dose, and a reinforcement job. Long time no see. The last time I saw such beautiful faces was in 2020 BC. Yani, before Corona. I was in year 7, guys. Now it's 2023 AC. Namaliza HCSE, guys.
And you can imagine that. From the deep state of the theater and performing arts, Brookhurst International School presents the Drama Festival.
Oh yes, the Drama Festivals. This is a period where all drama lovers like it most. This is a period where we never wish to be sent home because of school fees balance. This is a period where all our lovely adjudicators are loved and hated with equal measures. This is a period where our drama patrons don't see eye to eye with the school principal because of budgeting exiting the co-curriculum activities.
Guys, this is a period where our own drama students miss preps because of late rehearsals. Our own drama patrons have to make extra money from our costumes, decorations, and other things. Some even ask for money. Money for expectation, expression, and storyline development from unsuspecting principals.
To you, you, and all of you about our last year's drama festival. It should be noted that we carried all sorts of competitors and participants. There are those whom we call the big fish. Yani, wale mabazu, eh? The ones with the best experience, the ones with the best experience and the best actors.
This is the best time to perform, especially when the hall is full and packed. Some people take up to only 2 hours of just setting up what you can see around you. Yet, people arrive late to their teams, and then chinyamaji ni kupolish na kuhas.
Na kuna wale ma small fish, with 2 to 3 backdrops, civilian clothes as costumes, a hired matatu, van, or lorry as means of transport. Na guys, viazi chemsha as lunch. Lakini, all that matter to them is to participate.
Gentlemen, among all the schools that we had here today, there's only one school that had captured all our attention, and that was Kiburi Group of Schools. Kiburi Group of Schools is known for their pride. Why? Because of the excess resources, the full support from their head principal, the director of the county, ADCSO Education, the area chief, their school chefs, their school drivers, and guys, it's rumored that Adi our judges welcome on our support.
We from Ushindi Sponsored Secondary School were among the participants. We had no high hopes of winning because of such competitors. We did our best, had the best script, had the best actors, had the best facial expression, had everything good for the competition.
Despite our weak financial state, our drama patron was a man of little experience. Yani, hakuwa anajua vitu nyingi, but he was smart, he was brilliant, he was strong and a God-fearing man. Every single day, he gave us high hopes of winning this competition, and his voice could be heard outside our changing room saying, "Mi nakaa mtu wa kuibiwa hii kitu kweli." Preparation picked momentum. Rehearsals were given top priority to schools that valued drama. Schools wrote the best script, selected cast, and of course, best trainers. We did thorough rehearsals at home, dressing rehearsals with other schools, and even went to those schools to perform for them to get good comments and improve, well knowing that our own competitors were more advantaged than us. On the other hand, ladies and gentlemen, the Kiburi group of schools did little rehearsals, toured big hotels, relied on their old play script, recruited the former Form 4 repeaters, chased away the energetic Form 2s because of lack of school fees. And guess what, guys?
What?
They later joined us.
Unakumbuka ile day festival.
Hey.
All schools were there, both competitors and participants, ready to win this thing. Some presented serious scripts, while others just skits.
The Kiburi group of schools presented their play full of pomp and color. They only concentrated on expensive backdrops, media publicity, and expensive Italian costumes, forgetting that they were only working with 10 marks. They took an early lead. Nevertheless, Ushindi Sports at secondary school went on stage with only 3 backdrops, borrowed our costumes with a good script, refined cast, and presented our play well on the current issues facing our country, like drought, famine, and the audience was so moved by this that they gave us an outstanding ovation. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment our honorable judges turned into horrible judges, all participants are called into the hall for the release of the results.
The hall was full to capacity with the audience, the sponsors, the students, and well, of course, our drama patrons. After several minutes of compiling results and tallying comments, the judge rose to announce the winner in several categories.
Surprisingly, the Kiburi group of schools drama The Kiburi group of schools drama patron was apparently missing in the hall.
Huh?
Everybody knew he was after some drama after drama. The judges rose to read out the general comments and awarded the winners.
The judges' awards went to Kiburi group of schools. The best decoration and costumes went to Kiburi group of schools. The best male actor went to Ushindi Secondary School. The best female actor went to Ushindi Secondary School, and yet again, the best English play was Ushindi Secondary School. And you know what, guys? The overall winners were Ushindi Secondary School. Oh.
our celebration was later cut short by the Kiburi Group of Schools drama patron shouting,
"We may be tina, we may be. This is delicious, come on, Chanel. Hello, work at Patia Kikumbi Tottenham. This is not what we should do at Timundogo, come at Tottenham."
The results were opaque, and he was challenging us in the head office. We were perplexed.
Wacha, Nikuliza, my friend. Kwani timu shulendogo haiwezi shinda hii kitu? Wacha nikuulize my friend, watoto wa mahasala hawezi shinda hii kitu? Watoto wa mama wa mboga na bodaboda hawezi shinda hii kitu?
Meanwhile, our God-fearing patron made sure that we all stayed calm as we awaited for the ruling of the council. When evidence was finally brought forward, guys, the things he had. Oh, Siji Mara, our drama patron, was working with the judges. Ati one of our teachers was the secretary of the judges. Ati mpesa inatembea.
Ladies and gentlemen, hauchi hua. The council upheld our win in consistency presented by the Kiburi Group of Schools, calling it hot air. Can you imagine a whole school bus carrying hot air?
Ladies and gentlemen, with good preparation and adequate practicing, be trusting in God, which is key to success. Usiwai jidharau kuwa hawezi.
He wrote love letters to me and placed them inside his answer book. I don't even know where he got my number from, and yet he's been sending me dirty pictures on WhatsApp. Yesterday after class, he followed me. He spoke to me in a romantic voice, and he even touched me. Here's the evidence.
Nicodemus, the accusations against you are grave and punishable by immediate suspension.
Madam Principal, these are all false allegations made by these same male teachers who also show interest in Madam Kess.
Nicodemus, who do you live with back at home?
Baba Nicodemus. It's been 3 years since you divorced me. Have you been denying me access to see my own son?
Let us operate within the limits of the court order.
Court order. Lazaro, who knew about me, seduced me, took all my innocence as I endured the pain of killing your son. Is there a court order?
Those are passing memories. My mind is only to remember the important part of life.
Nicodemus is about to sit for his examination. Motherly guidance is critical and essential at this point of a child's development. I never brought the Bible to guide him in my absentia. Please leave the court order so that I may see my son in school.
Milka, you have now become a burden. Court orders are court orders.
Then was then. Today, I must see my son. Court order or no court order.
Do you live with back at home?
Woman, this is the last time that I'm telling you that Dawoodi
is the only unborn father that is allowed to visit Nicodemus. Now, give me the Bible and I will personally deliver it to school.
Surely. Where is the world heading to? Parental obligations are now left in the hands of a houseboy. How the mess can have done this? Where did I go wrong?
Milka! Hold your biblical renditions. Let the rights from the Book of Lamentations and adhere to the court order. If you dare set foot in that school, you will be liable for a 6 months imprisonment.
Hey, Lazaro, how will you let a houseboy speak to your
school?
My own father,
I have delegated my parental responsibilities to Dawoodi.
Dawoodi can just take your role as
a sir, your next flight to Seychelles is I have already made up my mind. I am now Nicodemus' mother.
I have already made up my mind. This disciplinary committee finds you, Nicodemus, guilty of seducing a female teacher and placing her under unnecessary discomfort. Go! Wait at the disciplinary square as I process your suspension letter.
Thank you.
School square?
Antoinette, these are just mere fabrications.
Is it true that you're going to suffer suspension? Nicodemus, my fingers are gone.
What? You missed your peers again? You're not leaving this school. Antoinette, my mind is currently confused with these allegations from Madame Kessinger. Please, just relax.
I'm telling you to the principal.
Antoinette, listen to me, please.
Hey, I'm going to stay in force with me.
You are too willing!
Nicodemus, you confuse me!
Antoinette, the burdens that I carry are too heavy for me to hold. As of right now, I'm already destined for suspension. Once the principal hears this, I shall be expelled.
Hey? Antoinette!
Antoinette! No. Sweetheart!
What? Nicodemus, call your first self. Who is she?
She's Yatenbi.
Yatenbi?
I mean, she's Valerie.
What does she want? For the last time, have your pastor. Now your boyfriend's a special. Was she your girlfriend? Is she also a girlfriend? Nicodemus!
Leave me alone!
Nicodemus!
I have a mercy next time.
And that's being compassionate. I'll walk in every one of you. And ask everybody to do the course. You say this is an out personal extension.
Valerie, I never seduced you. I just said you had gorgeous eyes and you love my heart.
Gorgeous eyes again!
Take that letter and go home! Grab your budget and head to the school parking lot. Thank you.
as private and confidential.
Wait, woman, kindly introduce yourself to us and tell us, are you a self-pensioner? I am Milka. This is my son, Nicodemus, my only son.
She is not Mama Nicodemus.
Mama Nicodemus. Mama Nicodemus is a bona fide member of this school. And you have to know this. Money.
assault.
Well, it seems that his problems emanate from the lack of parents at home, right?
I am now a very busy man. As you see, I have missed very important flights because of this.
Dowdy cannot take the role of offering guidance to Nicodemus. He's going to take his life away.
Surely, Mother Nicodemus, just allow her back into her son's life.
Certainly.
It's the only way to ensure that he gets good morals.
So open your eyes and see that your decisions are ruining your own son. Please just open your eyes.
Sir, your son has become a bully.
No, a bull. Oh, it's just I'm telling my Lisa. Sawa. Please allow me to make a drastic change in my family. Wait, out!
Yes,
you are now fired!
What? And arrested for impersonation.
I am Milka. I am now sorry and I regret separating you from my own son.
Mom, I'm sorry.
Milka, I hope you find it in your heart to forgive my actions. And please come back to take care of Nick.
As the principal, I'll initiate a parent-teacher-student initiative that will ensure proper cooperation and coordination between the three stakeholders. The three are the pillars that must be strengthened for the proper functioning of a school.
Principal and teachers, I want to thank you. The dream to be with my son has finally come true. I am very delighted.
My name is Wanjiko Mwaura. I am a parent in Brookhurst International School. My son is in year 10. He's called Liberty Lucas.
So what is happening today?
Today was a very special day which I could not have missed for anything. It was so special because it's something personally I've never seen. And though I've been an older parent in this school, I've had two other children, it had never been done before. This was a black tie event. I had to come because the school has very nice arrangements where children are given time to showcase their dress-up styles and present themselves in style. So I just had to come. My son Liberty was acting in a very interesting play. It's called The Burden, and he acted so well. Just by looking at him, he first acted as the principal. I just thought of him owning a school and becoming a principal of a certain school, maybe Brookhurst at one time in life. Secondly, he acted as a servant and he acted so well. Actually, I did not know he had such skills. I'm so touched by what Brookhurst teachers do to students. They nurture them. They bring out something in them that us parents may not have known. So I am so impressed. Out of what I've seen today, the children here are very confident. They know how to present themselves, to walk in style. The young men in particular are so stylish. They walk in confidence. The girls are so healthy. They are beautiful. The highlight of the day was the lesson in the play called The Burdens. The highlight is that most of the times, we are too busy as parents. We go looking for money. We go into our businesses and we leave our children in the hands of people who really don't have their best interest at heart. Sometimes this, which is important, albeit our busy schedules, we should try and know the people, the house helps, the assistants, domestic assistants. It is important to interrogate them and to find out what kind of people they are, because they are going to compromise our hard work and mislead our children. Dawdy is the one who misled that young man, exposing him to very dirty material, and finally that young man's life was used to destroy many other lives. So parents, our work is bigger than looking for money. Our work is to nurture the children into great people. I think it is a very nice forum where children are able to see themselves more than bookworms. They are able to nurture the talents inside of them. Because I've come to realize, in our ages, what was looked at mostly was the academic performance. If some of us were given the chances these children have, we would probably not, we would be more. And I believe children are made for more. We are made for more than our careers. We have talents, and that's why I love Brookhurst, because it nurtures the talents of our children and also makes them, helps them to perform academically. An all-rounded person is created through these forums.
So today in Brookhurst International School, we had our first annual black tie event. There were numerous events where there was dancing, singing, and basically a showcase of talents. There was also the highlight of the day, a play called The Drama, The Burdens, I mean. It's the play about a boy known as Nicodemus, who lacks parental guidance and is raised by his houseboy, Daudi. Such a play helps me in, like, when I come to look at the character of Nicodemus, I see that he's a troubled and conflicted boy, and so through everything that happens throughout his life, you can see that the kind of things that he has been led into doing is not proper, because he has numerously been known for cheating in exams, bullying other students, and other things. This is wrong, and students shouldn't really do this. So what I learned from this play was that each one of us has different burdens that we carry, but we can all work together to solve them.
My name is Ashley Wanja. I'm in Brookhurst International School, and today we were doing Masquerade Black Tie. The importance of this event is to nurture our talents, to have fun, and to boost our confidence. What I learned is that this school can help us to nurture our talents.
My name is Sashani Momwangi from Brookhurst International School, and today we were having our very first Masquerade Ball. It was a very interesting event where we got to do drama, choir, and dances. And I hope that we'll be able to do this again in the future.
My name is Blessing Toriso Muyoma. The importance of such plays is to increase a student's motivation of speech and their own stage frights. As you get to play here, you get to learn to shout more, have more verbal communication with others as well.
My name is Sir Hannington Onzere, a teacher of English, Literature and Drama. The importance of such plays to students is that, one, they help them in mastering English language. As they converse on stage, they master the lines. Two, preparing them to be actors, as I said. Three, these plays help and market the school. Because when we do our acting and we do it very well, I know students who are interested in acting, those who are interested in film, will definitely join us, and with hopes that we shall nurture their talents. The message in this play is that students, parents, and teachers must coordinate for the proper functioning of a school. Parents must be able to take up their parenting role and not neglect or abdicate their roles and leave them to the caretakers. They should actually create time for students. That's what actually I learned from this play.
I would like to appreciate all the parents who have given us company this evening, and all our stakeholders who have spent the day with us, and wish you safe journey home. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we come in front of you this evening to thank you that we requested that you be with us throughout the day, and you have done exactly that. We are heading home. I would like to request that you give us a good journey, and that when we get home, we'll give thanks. We also like to request that you give us a sound night, and that you also provide for our families. Thank you so much. And in those few words, we pray and believe. Amen.